Good day all and welcome back to another Michael John Arniak extravaganza. I am working on a program called Thummm, the human music machine. Right now we're capturing system microphone into a program called Guitarix, spelled there, and this allows us to have really annoying control over the audio. And there we go. For example, we've got a chorus clean on now. Completely different sound, right? There's things like bass boost. Turn on presence. Presence is a really nice filter. And then there's things like reverb. It's going to sound like you're on a toilet or a spaceship or pre and master gain. And then your overall master volume. Clean versus distortion. Yeah, and then you have that to drive. I'm getting feedback from my headphones and the mic, so I'll turn that shit down. And I just wanted to show you really quickly that even with this harsh EQ on the microphone, I've got this software that I'm working on that is, discarding lower frequencies, but picking up frequencies of my speech from the microphone. And so if I make like a whistling sound, very cool working on some Python code that can do some MIDI output as well. And it goes down to frequency analyzer, maybe a little more gracefully, and switch over to this.
Y-M-U-G-M-R-S-Q-H-U-O-K-F-I-N.
You see here, we've got re-noise getting triggered from a Python program, which is randomly doing notes from MIDI note 34 to 61, and does it 20 times. We can make the notes happen a lot faster if we comment out this line, save it, run it again, listen. And so we could also go to re-noise and go into it. And then run this script again. Whoops. Hit the stop button. Anyways, we get some really cool fast Fourier transform microphone input code to frequency, which is going to be useful as a input controller and also for doing real-time MIDI by whistling or uttering or humming. I know it's complicated. And let's see here if we can run this again. Let's take a look at down here in this window how a note can be held very securely, even with all this noise of the distorted amplification on the mic, which doesn't have to be there, I just like the way it sounds. Wait a minute. We got the bottom of the scroll window there. Sounds there, but I liked it. And you can see that the program is barely responsive with very little latency. Yeah, right on. Okay, let's going to release this soon on thehumanmusicmachine.com, thehumanmusicmachine.com, and maybe we'll have to redo this video, maybe not. It's real, alright? Okay, it looks like we're recording the video, and I want to show you something cool I found using MIDI. And MIDI is a is a Vishnu. Look for MIDI. MIDI GitHub MIDI. There we go. Yeah. So olemb/MIDI, and in the examples for MIDI files, there is play MIDI file, and it's run this command Python play MIDI file.py and the name of the MIDI file. And this is Robert Miles' children's song played through Renoise, which right now has Neutron something or other, Neural Funk Sweeper. Anyways, it's crazy. I'm going to change some samples as we're playing this, and you can hear the difference, but this is a simple Python program. This is all the code. It's going to play a MIDI file through Renoise. Check it out. And we've got a program. I just added some MIDI code, four lines here to create a note on or off. I'm not using this line yet, but basically sends a note on command through MIDI, the note on, the channel, the note, the velocity. If you want to turn it off, then you set the velocity to zero. The include code for that is like super simple. That's it. And then here's the code using RT MIDI to just do 20 random notes. Very simple. And let's take a look at this. Check this out. So we've got a Renoise hooked up with a marimba, and we're using this as a sample recorder to get microphone into light paint here, which we can see in these connections over here. Right now he's going into GST launch with red lines there. And in the Renoise, we've got a Maramba set up with the MIDI to come in on MIDI port through zero through this program here, which is grabbing chunks of microphone data, doing some fast Fourier transform, putting it into an array, then displaying it on a graph, and then a grass. Yeah. Tongue is tied up today, and a graph, and then we extract the frequencies with the maximum in the array and convert it to a MIDI note for this beautiful line here. The note, or the MIDI note, equals an integer of 12 times math.log frequency in hertz divided by 200, blah, 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 blah. Get the idea. Anyways, check this out. Okay, cool, we just added some really sweet improvement to Thummm the Human Music Machine here. We've added a turn off all notes and then trigger a new note on a signal. Right now we got it clamped that if the frequency is below 150 Hz, it ignores it. That value should be adjustable for the user. But check out the code now. Triggering some MIDI stuff from the Renoise. We'll turn off the mic.
Thank you.
is seriously cool. We just recently made some changes where before we played the notes, we shut them all off in a loop, which is here. And I also added a couple variables, old frequency and freak in hertz. And we need to declare the global at the top of the program as well. We do that. We did it here, yeah. So you say global, the variable, and then set the variable to a value. And then in your function within the class or whatever it is, you write there and there. And then if the frequency hertz is greater than the trigger value, then set the old frequency to the current frequency. Next time the frequency gets checked, we can say if the old frequency is different than the frequency, then re-trigger or trigger a new note. But this will keep notes from getting repeated, like so check this out. Oh yeah, so I'm gonna turn off the mic here, and what we're gonna do is do 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 sort of thing, and it's going to play this French horn here.